Good morning, y'all. What is good? It is Mark Turner with Turned Up Fitness. Hold on, the light gonna go off in a second. All right, y'all. So I'm sitting there, walk to the edge of my. Before we get started, we're gonna do something different. So we got this situation going on in the world, this pandemic known as COVID-19 or coronavirus. So I got this paper on my driveway, and look what the first word on top was. Resilience. Let me tell you about that word. So let me tell you, this is amazing. So let me read this to you real fast so you know that I can read, okay? At Eastside Medical Center and across our HCA healthcare network, we're no stranger to threats. We deal with them daily. Infectious diseases, natural disasters, unspeakable emergencies. Some may say that managing life-threatening situations is part of the business as usual for an advanced healthcare network like HCA Healthcare, and it's true. Thankfully, that's exactly what has helped us build a sharp set of best practices and a robust network of response teams who help us mobilize quickly and scale accordingly in times of need. Let me tell you something. As the threat from the COVID-19 virus is amplified, so too are our efforts. Here are just a few of the steps we are taking to assure uninterrupted care. Now check. We're limiting entry into hospitals and clinics so anyone who enters into patient care areas can be carefully screened and masks can be provided to those who need them. That's one of the benefits. Every employee, caregiver, and physician has been asked to follow a self-screening procedure. Because protecting our patients starts with protecting our people, another benefit. As always, cleaning to prevent the spread of infection is occurring throughout all our care sites, another benefit. Precautions taken to treat patients with COVID-19 are similar to those taken to treat patients with influenza, with restricted visitation to limited exposure. This is commonplace procedure for us during any flu season. Listen to it. To date, there have been relatively low patients with COVID-19 who require hospitalization. Those who do are cared for in an isolated area of the hospital so we can safely provide continuous care for all other medical needs. Now, this is coming from Eastside Medical Center. And the way they close out with this actually comes from Trent Lind, the chief executive officer of Eastside Medical Center down here. I think it's in Atlanta. So I don't be home so much. I don't pay attention. I don't go downtown a lot. But the point of this right here is this. This is what he closes out with right here. As this latest threat evolves, we are collaborating with federal and local health agencies, providing timely and practical updates that will help contribute to accurate reporting and consistent guidelines, while our immediate priority remains on the well-being of our patients and people. We know that sharing insights can impact care far beyond the communities we serve. In the face of a threat, we don't panic, we prepare in the weeks ahead. And as always, we are here when you need us. Let me tell you something. I'm gonna say something about that right there. I know this video may not resonate with a lot of people, but I'm gonna put this out there anyway. I haven't been doing any Q&As this week. I have not done any Q&As recently. And the only reason I haven't done it, I've been driving, so I can't really focus on the Q&As and get my research done to answer those questions for people. But what I've been talking to me and my wife talked about was this. We talked about businesses. We talked about life. We talked about a lot of things in general. And I'm gonna be honest with every one of y'all out there. There's a lot of people not taking this thing serious. There's a lot of people running around, still partying and doing all these different things. And this is what spreads these viruses. Now, if you're one of these people out there and you're not, and I guess they passed the rule no more than 10 people. I'm looking at these folks down here at a beach or whatever and they're partying like rock stars. Let me tell you something, man. This is, if you think for 1 second that you're above this, if you think that you're going to survive through this and you're going to continue to live the same lifestyle, like I said yesterday in my video, I said either you're going to come out better or you're going to come out worse at the end of the day. I wanted to give y'all some positive notes today too, and I want to keep these videos positive. So what we're starting to do, and I'm going to offer this to anybody that wants to participate, I wanted to challenge all of y'all to go out there and to do 500 by 3. With the 500 by 3 is this, is 500 squats, 500 push-ups, and 500 sit-ups every single day while we're in quarantine. We call it a quarantine workout, whatever. Also, what I'm going to do, and I'm not exploiting you in a way where I'm trying to make profit, but I want to make money. Yes, I do. Anybody want to make money, we can make money. But I'm not looking at it from the perspective of me being in the building. I'm looking at it from a perspective of time. What I'm doing, what I've done, I've created an online program, online personal training. I have live, what we're going to probably do on weekends. We got to know a lot of people got some things happening throughout the week. And we're going to do, I have the actual program where you can actually purchase the program. Now, I know there's some people out there doing Zumba, which, let me tell you something, I'm not knocking nobody's hustle. I'm actually happy that people are really starting to get the gist of being in good health, okay? So you got people out there doing Zumba classes. You got some people doing some other type of classes out there online, and that's great. There's live classes, and there's also recorded. The thing about recorded is that I think some people still need to have their hands held to have accountability, but then you have the live, which I think is more, which is a better fit for most people. I'm doing online personal training. I haven't started it up yet, and the reason why, I just got back. So a lot of my clients are like, I thought we'd get started. Look, man, I'm driving. I'm trying to get home. And I'm being honest with everybody. When you are on that road, your mind is focused on the road and you're driving. When you get off that road late, you're tired. And I'm staying up as late as I possibly can to try to finish up everything. Luckily, I'm dealing with a good company when it comes to my mobile design. They actually helped me out a lot, and I really appreciate them. I'm gonna send them an email, tell them I really appreciate their help. And I really appreciate everybody out there that follows me. First of all, I don't have the most massive amount of followers, but I'm going to get there. But I want to do it in a way where I'm actually giving great value. And I have not felt like I've been giving you the best value of myself due to me still working a job. But guess what? Things about to change and everything will pop off. So always think like this. Either you're going to come out better at the end of this, or you're going to come out worse. It's really up to you what you want to do. But look, I ain't going to keep running my mouth. I got to do a Q&A this morning, so I'll talk to y'all soon. Mark trying to turn up fitness. You know what time it is, right? I think I got it on this hat. Yeah, right there. This is my old hat. No excuses. I haven't been buying a lot of gear lately. I have not. Y'all stay blessed. Stay turned up. We'll talk soon.